Hello everybody, Interintere back again with another video. And today's video, guys, I just want to talk about the 2020 season so far. It is pretty early on the season. We are just 3 months early in the season. What do I think about the season so far? Has the season progress like I have expected and things like that. Let's start with what have I expected the season to become like it has become so far. Yes, I expected Novak won Australian Open like we many of us believe that he will do. He was the big favorite in Australian Open. And he prevailed there, like we all know. And then after that, Monfils, he has won 2 tournaments. Tsitsipas has won 1. And now lately, Medvedev has not looked super good. No, he hasn't. He lost one of his matches, one set, 6-love. That is not good for a top 10 player. That is not good for a former Grand Slam finalist. That is not good. So, I'm not happy with Medvedev's start of the season. Not that I'm a fan of Medvedev by any means, because I'm not, but we need fresh blood. We need new blood to come to the tennis scene. I love tennis. I love the big three, Federer, Nadal and Djokovic. But I'm a big tennis lover. I need new names to come to the scene. And Medvedev has not delivered so far this year. Felix Aliassime, he is continuing to lose these finals. He is losing and losing and losing. Yeah, I think he has played 2 ATP finals so far this year. Lost both of them. I think he played 3 last year, if I'm not mistaken. Correct me down below if I'm wrong. Now Felix has lost 5 ATP finals and he's 19 years old. For God's sakes, players like Nadal and Djokovic, they were winning Grand Slam titles when they were 19 years old, especially Nadal. He was 19 years old when Rafa won his first Grand Slam title. Djokovic was 20. So, obviously, of course, that Felix has time on his side, but he needs to start to deliver in those finals, for God's sakes. 5 straight finals he's losing. And don't get me wrong, I'm not angry. I am disappointed. And the way he's losing these finals, he's not even close to winning them. He's losing them straight sets. Straight bloody sets. At least these 2 finals this year in 2020, he has lost them in straight sets. In 2019, those 3 finals that he lost, I don't remember if there were straight sets. It can have been straight sets, those 3 as well. Correct me, but I think, I'm not sure in this one, that he has lost all of his 5 finals, Felix Aliassime, in straight sets. Is he a choker? Most probably, yes, he is a choker. Most probably, he gets nervous. Yeah, I know, the hardest match to win is when you play the final, not the first round or second round, because you are facing the dude who has won all his matches during the week, exactly like you, and the most difficult match to win is the final. But, Felix, we have big expectation on him. We have big expectation on him. I have big expectation on him. He needs to start winning these finals. He needs to start doing it. Medvedev needs to start to win some matches. He cannot continue being bageled, for God's sakes, a former Grand Slam finalist. He got bageled last match he lost. He got bageled. Tsitsipas, he has been okay. Not superb, okay. He won a tournament. At least in Marseille, I believe. I think he won Marseille. And he was in the final in Dubai. But who has sent the message? Who has sent the message to the rest of the field? Of course, Djokovic, the world number 1. And of course, Rafael Nadal, the world number 2. It is gonna be about these 2 in this 2020 season, guys. It's gonna be about these two. They are sending the message already. In March, it will be the first March tomorrow. They are sending the message because, and they are saying to the rest of the field that we are here to stay, even though that Rafa, I am 33 years old, Rafa, Novak is 32 years old, but they are winning. Novak, he has not lost a match this year. He has not lost a freaking match. You have to be impressed. Yeah, I know, he was three match points down against Gael Monfils. But have we not seen this before? Have we not seen this before from Novak Djokovic saving match points and winning the tournaments? Have we not seen this before? It is not a coincidence. Novak Djokovic is a Terminator up here. He is a Terminator. When you have the chance, you have to eliminate him. Because he will not give you second chances. Just ask Roger Federer. Ask Roger Federer. He knows bloody well all what I'm talking about. And Gael Monfils, he tasted the same medicine in that Dubai semifinal. I'm impressed from Novak Djokovic. I would be crazy if I'm not impressed from Novak Djokovic. The way he saves these match points, the way he bounces back and wins this tournament, he is a Terminator up here. He is mentally a Terminator. That's why I've always said, Roger and Rafa, they don't even come close Novak Djokovic mentally. They just don't. If Rafa and Roger wants to beat Novak Djokovic, in slams, outside slams, you name it. They need to eliminate him in straight sets or in four sets. Because when the match goes to the distance, Novak Djokovic will take his two big rivals down. Just look at the past. Roger and Novak, I believe they have played four matches in Grand Slams when the match goes to the distance. Three in Wimbledon. No, two in Wimbledon and two in US Open. Novak has been the winner in all of those four matches. And against Rafael Nadal, Novak has played three matches when the matches has gone to the distance. One in French Open, one in Wimbledon, and one in Australian Open. And Novak has won two of them. The Australian Open, that epic 6 hours battle in 2012, that final, one of the greatest matches of all time, if you ask me, the greatest match of all time, in my opinion. And the other one in 2 years ago in that Wimbledon epic one in the semifinal where Novak also won. The only match that Rafa has taken Novak down when the matches has gone to the distance is in that 2013 French Open semifinal. One of the greatest clay court matches of all time. No, I will change that. The greatest clay court match of all time, in my opinion. That was a huge battle. And Novak, he came short there. Rafa won that battle. What I want to say is that for Rafa and Roger to take down this Terminator mentally, they need to do it in three or four sets. Because when the matches go to the distance, they will not have a chance. They just will not have a chance. Novak is a machine up here. He's a machine. You are seeing that yourself, guys. I don't need even to say that these kind of words to you. You are seeing this yourself. Novak, he's probably not in his peak of his career. He's not. But mentally, he is just impeccable. He's impeccable mentally. So Novak is sending a message, Rafa is sending a message. Novak won his second tournament, his second title in 2020, now in Dubai yesterday. Rafa won his first title in this year, in this new season 2020. And it will be all about these two. What can we say about these next gens, middle gens, last gens, call it what you want, team? What has team done after the Australian Open? Yeah, he traveled to Buenos Aires and he was knocked out pretty early. What has Medvedev performed? Not so good either. Tsitsipas, like I said earlier in the video, okay, not superb. He has won at least one title, Tsitsipas. And in Dubai, Tsitsipas was all right, okay, too. He went to the final, but I guess, look, I am not impressed from these next geners. I really am not. They need Djokovic and Nadal. They are continuing winning. They are continuing dominating the tour. Tsitsipas, he is, for God's sakes, 21 years old. He should push Novak Djokovic more. Novak just took him out in straight sets in that Dubai final. I expect more from Stefanos Tsitsipas, but Stefanos, he needs to work on that backhand. He doesn't do a lot of that backhand. Sometimes his backhand can be really good and really he hits that with a great depth, but not often against Djokovic in that final. His backhand is landing too short. It is landing way too short. His returns are not superior either. His returns lack depth. Novak Djokovic, we all know what Novak Djokovic is good at. I don't need even to explain that to you guys, because you who watch my videos, you know tennis bloody well. Djokovic, it is all about depth, 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 depth. I could say depth of the entire day. When Djokovic is at his best, his balls, they land on his opponent's feet. And to take the ball on your feet, you need to be really, really flexible. You need to have a great timing. You need to take the ball on the rise. And it is not all the players who can do this. Not many who can do this. And when Djokovic doesn't play at his best, he lands the ball short, his returns land short, but you don't see that too many times, you really don't. Often Djokovic has always good length, because when Djokovic doesn't have good length, he will be eliminated. But Djokovic is so careful to have good length, and this Rafa Nadal needs to take lesson from. Rafa, when Rafa is not at his best, his balls land short. His returns land short. He plays way too far from the baseline. That's why Rafa, he struggles against his top two sheet rivals, Federer and Djokovic, nowadays, and has done it many years now outside clay. Because Rafa needs to learn in his head that to beat Djokovic and to beat Federer, you need to take time away from them. His tactics to stay 2 meters behind from the baseline works against everybody, not against Djokovic, not against Federer, especially not against Djokovic, who is so good of taking the ball on the rise, who is so good of stepping into the baseline and take time away from you. Djokovic does that, and especially Djokovic's length is murder. It is so impressive. Nobody plays better, hits better balls with that kind of depth like Novak Djokovic does. So it is not easy to take down Djokovic. It is not easy, guys. Djokovic, look, guys, in my last video I did, when I said that Djokovic will not win 25 majors, and I still say he will not, I will be murderously impressed if he did. I will be murderously impressed. But he will for sure surpass Federer. He will for sure surpass Federer. What are these next gens doing? What are they doing? What are they doing? Tell me, what are they doing? Tsitsipas, he comes to the final and he loses straight sets against Djokovic. Tsitsipas, he needs to prove himself now. He needs to start beating these big guns, these big elephants, these big dogs. It is not enough beating the other dudes. It is not enough. Because we, the tennis world, we have big expectations on Stefanos Tsitsipas. At least I have. And he comes to the Dubai final and he just goes away in straight sets. He doesn't play good tennis. And how can I predict that Tsitsipas will win a Grand Slam title this year when he shows that this kind of performance like he did against Djokovic? How can I do? How can I predict? Or Medvedev? Or Thiem? How? They are not making my work, my analyze, easy. Are they doing easy for you? Are they doing easy for you? No, I am not happy with the next geners. I am not happy with middle geners. No. Guys, the only player who is a middle gen, he's not next gen, that can trouble Djokovic and Nadal. Sometimes it is Dominic Thiem. Dominic Thiem, he has firepower. Dominic Thiem, he has powerful ground strokes. But Dominic Thiem, he is a miss or hit player. If Dominic Thiem just has better shot tolerance, if Dominic Thiem makes better decisions, Dominic Thiem can challenge Djokovic and Nadal. He can do that, besides on grass, because in grass, Dominic Thiem is not superior, in my opinion. But on clay, in French Open, and in US Open as well, Dominic Thiem can take down Djokovic and Nadal. He can do that. But Dominic Thiem's problem is all these unforced errors that he hits. In one set, he can do 5 unforced errors. In the other, he can do 15. He is too way up and down. He needs to make better decisions, like in the last game in that Asyl Open final. I'm going to give you an example. Like in that last game in Asyl Open final, Djokovic is serving for the title. All right? Djokovic is serving for the title. And I have a pretty good memory. All right? The first point, Thiem wins it. Djokovic makes an unforced error, I believe. When Djokovic is serving for the title in that Asyl Open final. The second point, Djokovic does an ace. Nothing to do for Thiem. All right? He does an ace. So, not to blame Thiem there. The third point, now the match is 15-15. The third point, I think Dominic Thiem makes a backhand error down the line. Dominic Thiem, he didn't understand that night, that evening, his backhand down the line was horrible. And he kept hitting that backhand down the line. For God's sakes, Dominic Thiem, didn't you see that your backhand down the line that let you down in that final? Why continue hitting it, especially down the line? He found it better cross-court. He found it better cross-court. Why being stubborn and hit it down the line? I don't know how many unforced errors that dude did in that final with that shot. I don't know. But it was a lot. I know how many unforced errors Dominic Thiem did in total, 57. But I don't know how many he did with his backhand. But it, for sure a lot. And he continued hitting that horrible backhand down the line in the entire final. And he did an unforced error in that last game with his backhand down the line. 30-15 to Djokovic. So Djokovic is now 2 points away from winning the title. And the fourth point, Dominic Thiem does an unforced error with his forehand. So now Djokovic is 40-15. Djokovic is one point away of winning his 17th Grand Slam title and his 8th Asyl Open title. And of course then, Dominic Thiem finishes the match with an unforced error with his forehand. So, 5 points played in that last game. 4 unforced errors from Dominic Thiem. No, I'm sorry. 3. 4. 4. 4. 4 unforced errors from Dominic Thiem. No, 3. I'm sorry, 3. 3. Because one of the points Djokovic won with an ace. 3. 2 of unforced errors with his forehand and 1 with his backhand. Is it that way you stop a player of winning his Grand Slam title? Is it that way? At least make him win it. At least make him deserve it. Don't give him 3 gifts. Don't be a Santa Claus a la Roger Federer. Don't do it, Dominic Thiem. Don't do it. I was so angry. I was so mad. And some of you can say now, yeah, Inter, you're mad because you hate Novak Djokovic. No, guys, I don't hate Novak Djokovic because I've been accused to hate Novak Djokovic. One dude, he wrote to me, said, you Albanian, I don't know what he said, you are, because I'm Albanian, I hate Novak Djokovic because he's Serbian. No, guys, no, dude, it is not like that. It is not. You have not met a bigger human lover than me. Trust me. If I should say my history, my, what I do in life, everything I do, you will be shocked. But I'm not going to do it here. I'm not going to do it. I love human. For God's sakes, if you just knew what I do for humans. I don't hate Novak Djokovic. Why should I hate him? Am I crazy? Just because I'm Albanian and he's Serbian. Why? No. What has he done to me? Nothing. I want new champions. I want new champions. I want new bloods on the tennis. When did we have a player who was Grand Slam champion who was not named Federer, Djokovic or Nadal? When? Stan Wawrinka 2016 US Open. Stan Wawrinka 2016 US Open. And if we take out Stan, who is a multiple Grand Slam champion, when did we have a last time player who was a Grand Slam champion? Marin Cilic 2014 US Open. 6 years ago. Djokovic, Nadal and Federer, they will retire one day. Who will save tennis? Who will save tennis? Who? We need new champions. We need new champions, for God's sakes. Tsitsipas are not taking that big step. Medvedev is not taking that big step. Team is not taking that big step, even though the team and Medvedev, they have played Grand Slam finals. Team 3, Medvedev 1, but it is... I'm so disappointed on the way team played that last game with Djokovic in that semi-final. Look at Djokovic when Djokovic was under the ropes against Federer in that Wimbledon final last year. Look, did he give Federer gifts? We can say everything. We can say everything about Federer. Federer choked. Federer didn't choke. Federer was tight. Yes, Federer was tight. Federer didn't do a superior game in that game when he was serving for that Wimbledon title last year. But Djokovic, he gave Federer only one gift, only one gift, only one. Djokovic did only one unforced error in that game, only one. Because Djokovic is not team, he will make you play for it. He will make you play for it. He will send a message to you and say to you, if you want to be Wimbledon champion, you will freaking need to beat me. I will not beat myself. Dominic Thiem, he gave Djokovic three gifts. Three Christmas gifts. How can I not be disappointed? How can I not be disappointed? These 2020 guys will all be about Novak Djokovic and Rafael Nadal. It is all be about them. Maybe we will have a new Grand Slam champion in US Open. Maybe. But even there, I doubt it. I don't trust in Thiem. I don't trust in Tsitsipas. I don't trust in Medvedev. I don't trust in Zverev. I don't trust in anyone. And Federer is done. Federer is done. He just made a surgery in his knee. He's done. Federer is done. I don't need even to talk about that. Federer has had his last chance last year. Federer will not win any more majors. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and take care and bye-bye.